Hey everybody, and welcome to Monday with Michelle and Out Late But Great. Hope you all had a good weekend. This week is open topic week, so we can talk about whatever we want. And I was kind of perusing different articles online regarding LGBT worries and concerns. I don't know, I just started looking that up and it was because I was really curious what they were. And a lot of them are just the typical stuff that you'd assume, you know, being accepted and discrimination and all that stuff. But one of the ones that struck me, and it's something that I have experience with, was coming out at work. And I just wanted to follow up kind of because my coming out at work and eventually leaving work was something that I've documented on this channel and that you've all been a part of for a couple years now. And for people just tuning in, you know, I've been out since 08, so, you know, 8 years this year, once we get to the fall, and, eight of the 17 years, of the past 17 years, that didn't come out very well, but I don't feel like editing this, was spent working in a church. And when I first came out at church, I mean, everybody in, I'm a professional musician. Okay, so let me just start by saying that. And everybody in the choir, my music director and everybody was really cool. I did not experience any blatant homophobia, believe it or not, in the church. And even though I knew the church's policies, but there was no one that outwardly, at least I wasn't privy to anybody outwardly being discriminatory towards me, not that I know of. And so, you know, I kept my church job because I loved what I did. I loved the music, I loved my choir director, and I loved everybody that I worked with. And so I thought, you know, this is okay, this is gonna be fine. And so 8 years, the whole time after I came out, I worked there. And last year, when we had all of the great marriage equality breakthroughs that we did, there was an Episcopal convention, and the church as a whole, now, like, you know, the whole country, the general opinion of the religion as a whole was they were going to allow same-sex couples to get married in the church. But there was this like opt-out thing, and every parish was able to make their own choice whether or not they were going to participate in this decision. Well, of course, the place that I worked, right, decided to opt out. And it was so hard. I mean, you can go back, I'm not gonna go through all the emotions that I felt right then, but you can go back and reference a couple of videos. In fact, I might put a link to it below if I'm feeling really ambitious about how difficult it was for me to make the decision to leave, which I eventually did. And so, you know, I just wanted to follow up because now we're getting into April. So for a musician, for a classical musician, you know, you have a season. So your season basically starts in September and ends in May. And I cannot believe that I'm almost through like my entire season of not working at the church. So I've now gone through so first of all, this is the first set of holidays that I've ever spent with my wife, because as a church musician especially, you work every single holiday and usually many, many, many services around the big holidays like Christmas and Easter. And so this was the first set of holidays since I've been with my wife that she's seen me. And so I promised her a year, you know, when I left, I told her, I said, you know, I'm not going to take any other positions for a year. I want to spend a year's of holidays and Sundays with you. And so far I've done that. And so this was the first Thanksgiving, Christmas, Easter. Easter just passed. So basically those three holidays, that was the first time in 17 years that I had those holidays off from work. And it was really, I knew I had really come a long way when a month ago, or you know, like 47 days or whenever it was exactly, when it was Ash Wednesday when Lent started, I had no idea that it was actually Lent. Actually Ash Wednesday until it was like late in the day. And I'm like, wow, I had no concept. Because, you know, as a church musician, like you have your, you know, finger on the pulse of the liturgical calendar like 24/7. You know when everything is going to happen. And the fact that I did not even know it was Ash Wednesday just proved that I had really detached myself from my church job and disassociated myself from keeping up with the holidays of the religion, which I wasn't a part of that religion anyway. So this is why. I mean, if I was Episcopal, obviously I still would know. So now that I've gone through every single holiday, we're now in April, I'd only have a couple more months in my season for them. I just, like I said, I just wanted to check in and tell you how I felt. So it feels really good. You know, I've had a lot of people come up to me and go, how are you liking Sunday mornings? And I have to tell you that I love my Sunday mornings. And I think that the great thing about Sunday morning is, you know, even when you have Saturday, everything on Saturday night is completely tainted because you know you have to get up at the crack of dawn and go to your job. And so it's like not staying out late on a school night. It's that kind of thing. I wish I could turn my camera around really fast, but I know if I did that, they would disappear. But there are these beautiful cardinals in our bird feeder. I'm going to attempt. Wait, let's try. I knew that wasn't going to work. Sorry. I tried. Anyway, we had beautiful cardinals in our bird feeder. I digress. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Everything on Saturday is like tainted because it's like, you know, not going out the first day of school. So, for instance, this past Saturday, a couple days ago, we went to see Duran Duran in concert. And it was fantastic. I hadn't heard this band since, 35 years. Let's just say 35 years. And it was just as good, if not better, than it was before. And they all are just really fantastic musicians, so we had a great time. But I couldn't have done that if I was still working at my church job. So yes, I still miss the people. I still miss the actual music and my ex-boss, and a part of me misses being like locked in to the music scene in that way. I mean, I still have all my other music jobs, but it's just, I do miss it a little bit. However, the one thing, and this is kind of, we're coming back to the whole LGBT thing at work, I feel 100% liberated that I am completely out and accepted everywhere that I work now, and I'm self-employed. So, you know, it's just nice that, to my knowledge, I don't have any kind of negative thing that I face, you know, regarding having trusted and coming out in my job. I read an article that a couple of years ago, it was still at like 34% people did not feel comfortable coming out of work because they did not want to have to deal with homophobia, and they did not want to have to deal with discrimination and possible like being overlooked for a job promotion and stuff like that. So my question to you is, are you out at work and how do you feel about it? And how difficult do you think it would be to not be out and to be hiding your true self at work? Because I honestly don't think I could do it. I just feel like, well, I'm a Leo, you know? I feel like I have to kind of just be myself 24 hours a day or else I would just implode. So, I don't know. It's just me. My wife is better at that than I am. And she's way more diplomatic than I am too. So, qualities that I aspire to have that she's just really great at. Okay, well, you guys have a great week, and I look forward to all the topics this week because who knows what everybody's going to talk about. All right, have a good one, you all.